Let's take a closer look at full-size binoculars. But first, let's remind ourselves about those numbers we see on all binoculars. That's the numbers that look like an equation. Here are the numbers for a typical full-size binocular that's ideal for general purpose viewing. The first number, the 10, tells us the magnification is 10 times. This means the object we are viewing will be 10 times larger in the binocular view when compared with the naked eye view. Another way of thinking about this is that the object is 10 times closer. Imagine that you are looking at someone 100 metres away. In the binocular, they will seem as though they're standing only 10 metres away. The second number, the 50, is simply the size of the objective lenses, that's the lenses at the front here, in millimetres. The full-size binocular category starts at around 42 millimetres and goes up to 65 millimetres, this larger model here. Anything bigger and the binoculars becoming increasingly specialised for astronomy and very high-powered viewing. There are two basic types of full-size binocular. There's the traditional poroprism and the more modern roof prism. You can see that all other things being equal, the roof prism type are significantly more compact, but they tend to be slightly more expensive for the same specification. But at our prices, that's probably not a major worry. A good general use size of objective is 42 millimetres to about 50 millimetres. Outside of any considerations of weight and size, the central benefit of a full-size binocular is sheer performance. The large size of the primary optics ensure the broadest design freedom for the designer manufacturer, and therefore the absolute minimum compromise for the user. In simple terms, the optics are a proper match for the needs of the binocular. So here's our first obvious recommendation. If size and weight are not an issue, always opt for a full-size binocular. Everyone knows about the importance of magnification. It's what the binocular is about, after all, to make distant objects appear closer. And the extent to which they achieve this is a function of their magnification. Less obvious, but equally important, is the ability to collect light. That's the binocular's light-gathering power. And this is a really important point when considering binocular sizes. Quite simply, bigger lenses collect more light than small ones. Obvious, really. The larger objectives of full-size binoculars with moderate magnification, say 7 times or 10 times magnification, offer bright views in all lighting conditions, even in very poor light and deep twilight. This is an important factor for bird watchers, hoping to observe birds at roosting times, and of course good nighttime performance is vital if the binocular is to be used for astronomy. Bear in mind that full-size binoculars in the 7 to 10 magnification range will show you an image that is actually brighter than you can see with the naked eye. This power is unique to the full-size models. Binoculars with smaller optics simply can't do this because of the reduced light-gathering power. So let's sum up now with a few recommendations. For general bird and wildlife watching, select optics in the 42 to 50 millimetre range and magnifications no higher than 10 times. So our ideal recommendation would be an 8 by 42. For more serious observation of birds and other wildlife in situations where you want the best possible views in all lighting conditions and the increased weight of the binocular is not a problem, consider magnifications still in the 8 to 10 times range, but coupled with significantly larger objective lenses in the 56 to 65 millimetre range. But do bear in mind that these larger lenses will mean heavier binoculars, and holding them steady, you may need a tripod fitting bracket and a tripod. Our recommendation in this range would be the 8x56. If your interest is in longer range observation, perhaps of shipping or aircraft, look at binoculars in the 12 to 20 times magnification range with objective lenses in the 50 millimeter and above range. Do bear in mind that for prolonged observation at magnifications higher than 15 times, a tripod would be strongly recommended. Our recommendation would be either a 16 or 20 by 50. If you're buying binoculars for a gift and want to play safe with a general purpose full-size binocular, we would recommend either a 10-42 in a roof prism or a 10-50 in a poroprism. You'll be in good company as we sell more of these sizes than all the other full-size binoculars put together. I hope you found that helpful. Goodbye for now.